welcome to the 25th episode of The Window to Dubai.
Thank you for having me.
I'm here with the guy from Dubai.
Yes, sir.
You're actually known as TG.
TG from Dubai is the name that kind of picked up.
On Instagram, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So you recently started a production company called F8 Productions.
That's correct.
But you started out as freelance photographer. You were on photo missions, and then you kind of built a team and then launched this company. Can you tell us what F8 Productions actually does?
Yeah, F8 Productions is a content creation company that caters towards companies that want to do marketing and services that want to tap into different types of markets or marketing techniques. Yeah. So right now, social media is what's picking up. So we decided to target social media and create content for various entities or businesses or companies that want to utilize that platform to its full potential, which is storytelling in a sense. Besides the average photo, creating a story behind it.
Yeah, and I think what you guys are doing is you're creating the whole process, right? You're not just coming to someone saying, okay, you have an idea, let me go film it for you. You're coming to the client with the idea, the strategy, the whole process.
That's correct, yes. We actually create the content from A to Z. We write the script, we bring in the actors or actresses or models, we do the photography, the cinematography, the videos, everything else all in between. The only thing we ask is, depending on what we're shooting, we just tell the client, hey, what do you want to highlight? And provide us with these services or activities so we can use them or utilize them and put them in our videos or incorporate them in our script, which will showcase what you're trying to promote.
Yeah, and you're working in kind of hospitality, cars, you kind of have a few industries that you're already tapping into, right?
Yes, yeah. Hotels have been kind of big for us lately, and the car industry is always interesting, and they're kind of liking the idea of having a story behind their product instead of a static photo that just sits on Instagram, or a quick story that shows a car rumbling through the desert, which is cool. It's nice. That's always going to be there.
Yeah.
But it's more of adding the story element behind it of what happens next.
Yeah. And the way it kind of came about is you were going on these photo missions. That's actually how I started following you. I think you're like really one of the first people I started following in Dubai. Because, you know, when you're scrolling Dubai, your photos are always showing up for the good ones, you know. So
I think I got lucky.
Yeah. So I started following you there. And then I started following you going on these photo missions. And I think kind of as I was developing my show, you were kind of going on these missions and then kind of starting your production company. It sounded like you were kind of organically happening because you got like a group of professional photographers, right? And it kind of came together.
Yeah, what ended up happening was the photo mission idea was exactly what you just said. That was really big. It kind of took on a life of its own because the idea was one time I just decided to, well, I didn't decide overnight, but I've always been doing photography. And I just said, I picked up my phone and this new thing called Stories was just developing on Instagram. You know, it started to pick up. So I said, let me try it. I'm very vocal.
Yeah.
I'm not shy, obviously, so I can talk all day. I rumble a lot. And I said, well, let me talk to the people that are following me. Let me see what happens. So I tell them, Salaam alaikum, man. Good morning, everyone. That naturally became my saying, but talking to the people and say, well, I'm on top of Burj Khalifa right now, and I'm shooting this area. And people all just jumped in and said, wow, you know this? And they're messaging me while I'm doing my photo missions. So I was like, oh, people seem to like that.
Yeah.
So I started going out 5 times a week, you know, just like passionately.
Yeah.
What's what I love doing.
Yeah.
And then from there, it just kind of picked up because I have friends, most of my friends are photographers. They were doing something similar. And then we just kind of started doing photo missions together. Then the hashtag photo missions took off. So if you type in photo mission right now, hashtag photo mission, you'll see like a whole bunch of photos and videos, and most of them are not even mine. They just took over. You know, some people are using that hashtag a lot. So it promoted, so it got really big, and then my friends and I just said, hey, look, I want to do this full time. You know, the job I got is cool. It's nice. It pays the bills. Everything's great, but I'm ready to do this full time. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
And they were in too. They said, yeah, I mean, some of them are already full-time photographers anyway. And the rest wanted to do something like this.
Because you were actually having a corporate job at this point, right? And then you were doing the photo missions like after. You were kind of doing it on the side, even though I thought you were full-time because you were on Instagram all the time. I was like, I didn't realize.
I had no life, man.
Yeah.
Sometimes I didn't, honestly. It was really hard. I had a 96, well, they call it 96 or 95 in the US. But I was a COO of a company. And it was a great company, great bunch of people. But right after work, I'd just be excited. I just couldn't wait. You know, we had our own WhatsApp groups. All right, guys, who got permission for what tower today? Most of these towers that are on your wall over here, actually. And we'd have the permission all set up in advance. I'd call. I had already networked myself through with most of these companies, most of these administrations. And then they would approve us really quick, and we'd go. Wow. And then, it work, then photography, which was work, and then editing at night. Photos will be done late night and posted either that night or next morning.
Wow. So it really was, I mean, just a passion for photography really is what drove the whole thing, right? That you didn't start out to create a production company. It was just, you loved taking photos, you loved the mission, you loved doing it.
Exactly.
And then it just kind of organically came together.
Yes. Awesome. It's been, it just happened. I guess we could say, yeah.
You're actually originally from the United States, right?
Yeah, from the U.S., yeah. And a lot of people don't know that. And that's been in the U.S. my entire life.
And what brought you to Dubai originally?
Well, I started coming to Dubai in 2007, and I came to Dubai on business. I had an existing business in the U.S., and I wanted to bring it here. I had a partner that was out here. When I came down, Burj Khalifa wasn't up yet. The city wasn't built up yet. But actually, Burj Khalifa, I think, was either halfway or three quarters of the way. It was almost done.
Yeah.
But it wasn't all there yet. It was exciting, but it was amazing because when first time I came to Dubai at that time, I remember it was just, this place was in the middle of the desert. And when I landed, I was like, wow, this is a city. I'm like in New York City.
Yeah.
So it was amazing. I was blown away. And I love the people, the atmosphere and everything else. And I just, from there, I made the decision. 2 years after that, 2010, I moved.
Yeah.
Never went back. Never went anywhere else, actually. Yeah. So I've been in Dubai since.
Yeah. And so you came originally at a corporate job, right? You started out in the corporate world, or you came as...
Yeah, well, I had my own... I started off in the corporate world in the U.S. I worked for IBM, the MBA. Out of college, that's the passion was to be in IT and everything else. Then that long story, but that kind of turned into a corporate... I opened my own business. And then from there, I bought that here. Kind of had some issues, parted ways. Then I joined on with a company here, became the COO of a company, and I did that for about 6-7 years, and then decided to do what I'm doing now full-time.
It seems like Dubai would be a photographer's kind of heaven just because there's so many great imageries. It's really built for Instagram and pictures, right? Like, it just seems like it's built for that.
You know what? That's true, but that's based on the creativity of the photographer.
Yeah,
I run into a lot of people that message me all the time. How did you get this image? How did you get? I've been shooting in this area. I've been doing that and doing this, and then they can't seem to compose the right shot.
Yeah.
That takes practice. But Dubai is a beautiful city, and it has so much to offer. You can get amazing images if you're in the desert, if you're on the beach, if you're in a city, if you're in a village. You know, it's all on the creative drive of it.
I watched a video where someone was saying, I can give you all the ingredients you want,
but
if you don't know how to cook it, it's never going to taste good. Absolutely. So it's probably the same thing, right? Like, you can give someone the best camera in the world.
I couldn't have said it better. That absolutely makes sense, yeah.
If he doesn't know how to use it, it's pointless.
It's pointless, absolutely, 100%. I mean, a lot of people seem to think that going to rooftops, because rooftop photography became my thing for a while, that's what my photo missions look like, they're all rooftops. But in reality, if you look deep into my profile, I don't mean deep low, I mean like just look carefully, you'll see I'm most passionate about sunrise and sunset.
Yeah,
blue hour is amazing. I love blue hour because of the colors of the sky and everything else. That's just and rooftops, you're capturing the scene from really high. That's beautiful. But there's just something about composing an image that has a big large stone right on the edge of the water or the ocean. The water's blowing in and it's in between the sand, and you capture the image with the sun going up or going down. There's just a beauty in it and it has the sense of peace or tranquility. I don't know. You just feel really good about that. That's where my passion really is.
Yeah.
But if you would think that it's just
Like, that's awesome, man. No, it just sounds like you found what you love to do, and the ability to make money have kind of come together organically. It sounds like it just happened for you.
I think that's the dream, is we all want to do what we love or love what we do. And that's the whole line that they've been selling us growing up and school and everything else. And it's just trying to find it is really hard because we all love something, but then that one thing that we love, we find that it can't feed us, or we can't live off of it, or we can't. So we end up putting it aside. And then, I mean, if you look at my bio in certain areas that I have with certain companies right now, you'll see where I started with photography man, 20 years ago. And I loved it and left it so many times because it just seemed like a dead end or didn't seem like a place where I could make six figures or I could make money where I could be comfortable in.
Yeah.
Especially back in the 90s, just like, ah, that's not gonna happen, you know?
Yeah.
So I would have my camera equipment, I would shoot for fun. I loved photography.
Yeah. And now it came together, it's awesome.
And now it came together, yeah. And then 20 years ago, you'd ask me, I'd tell you, no, it's I don't think that's gonna be my future, it'll just be my hobby.
Yeah.
But it, I'm thankful that it's turning into my future.
What do you think you would give advice to maybe photographer, videographer, someone that's in that creative space that loves it but doesn't know how to make money at it? Like, what's the...
Well, I think you got to put the money thing aside first. And I know that's the hard part. Many people ask me, sir, how do I make money off of photography? I'm just starting off. If you're just starting off, you shouldn't be thinking of making money off of photography. Because you should, if you truly love photography, then go love it a little more. And then... through that love, you'll learn to understand how to use or shoot or compose and all the tools and techniques that you need. And I'm not talking about camera equipment here. That's necessary, but they're just tools at the end of the day that are necessary tools. But learning and understanding what photography is about is very important. And why, what is important about capturing an image or capturing a moment? You always hear that, these beautiful sayings. Come see Dubai through my lens, or capturing the world through my eyes, or through my lens, or through my view, or whatever you want to call it. Great sayings, great stories, great stuff. But my advice to them is go out and shoot as much as you can, but understand why you're shooting. If you feel like, all right, I truly love this, take it to the next level by understanding more about what photography is all about. I actually started researching what is photography. What's a 35 millimeter? What is 50 and 60? And then, you know, medium range cameras and all this other stuff, billboards. And like, why do people need to shoot with all this stuff? And why can't I just do it from my iPhone? And why, you know? Then I started to understand more and more. By understanding what this business was about, it turned into the idea of a business. Then I said, okay, now I can take the skills that I have, develop them, utilizing the tools that I have and understanding what these people want, and I can make money out of it.
Yeah. So I think it's a really great way to end the episode, but maybe you want to shout out your handles, Instagram, where people can find you and your company.
Yeah, TG from Dubai is what I'm known for. So if you guys want to check me out, all social media platforms, TG from Dubai. I have a YouTube, I vlog. The vlog idea actually shows people more of what photography is all about.
Like, or how, behind the scenes?
Yeah, behind the scenes, how I capture it. F8 Production is my dedication. So TG from Dubai is my handle. However, you guys will start noticing more and more in the coming days that I'm pushing F8 Productions, because that's what we're doing behind the scenes. And that's where my drive is going right now.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I appreciate you coming out.
Thank you for having me, man. Really appreciate it. Thank you.